I'm Dr. Keith Unger. I'm a radiation oncologist at MedStar Georgetown University Hospital. I'm director of the gastrointestinal cancer service and residency program director. I see patients to provide recommendations about radiation therapy. I primarily focus on treating gastrointestinal cancers as well as sarcomas, among other sites. The goal with radiation therapy is to kill cancer, often in conjunction with other cancer therapies, including chemotherapy and surgery. At MedStar Georgetown University Hospital, we have extensive experience in both proton therapy and experience with other advanced radiation therapy techniques. So whatever the patient's situation is or the indication of radiation therapy, we choose the best treatment modality for the individual situation because we have all these techniques available. Additionally, we have a strong multidisciplinary team in other departments so we can offer surgical services, oncology services, and other supportive care services that are necessary for comprehensive cancer treatment. I'm very excited to be able to offer proton therapy. I think it provides a very exciting option to patients in which we can improve our results over traditional radiation therapy techniques. It gives us another tool in our armamentarium against cancer and allows us to have additional options and choices for our patients. Over the last 10 to 20 years, we've seen rapid advancements in the technologies that we use for radiation therapy, as well as drug therapies that are used in oncology. With these advancements, we've seen real progress and improvements in patient outcomes. When I speak with patients, it's critical that I understand what they're looking to get out of their treatment. So when we have a conversation, I focus on trying to both educate them, provide recommendations, but really to understand what their goals of therapy are and to work to the best of my ability to meet those goals. Proton therapy is an advanced form of radiation therapy that uses protons, a charged particle, to deliver radiation therapy to treat cancer. Protons travel through tissue and release their energy at the end of their range, thus sparing tissue behind your target. This is as opposed to X-rays, which is a more traditional form of radiation therapy that is used widely to treat cancer, which travels through the target and out the back end, resulting in additional exposure of normal tissues to radiation as opposed to protons. Proton therapy is oftentimes a more precise form of radiation therapy. Because there's less normal tissue exposed to the effects of radiation with proton therapy, it's possible to increase the dose of radiation, thus potentially being a more effective therapy, or it's possible to decrease the normal tissue exposed to the effects of radiation, thus reducing the side effects, both acutely in the short term or long-term following radiation treatment. Proton therapy can be used throughout the body. In the gastrointestinal tract, the strongest evidence for using proton therapy is treating liver cancers. There's evidence to indicate vast improvements over traditional radiation techniques using proton therapy to treat cancers that start within the liver, or even metastatic cancers in highly selected cases. Liver cancers include cholangiocarcinomas, which are bile duct cancers, or hepatocellular carcinomas, cancers that develop in the primary liver cells. So there are many GI cancers that can be treated with proton therapy, including pancreas cancer. So in certain scenarios, proton therapy can offer a benefit in treating pancreas cancer as compared to traditional radiation techniques. At MedStar Georgetown University Hospital, we have a variety of options to treat pancreas cancer, including proton therapy. We also have the option of CyberKnife. So we have a number of treatment modalities, and we would consider which modality would be best for each individual patient. We think about proton therapy as an option in three general scenarios in treating esophageal cancer. Firstly, in what we call the preoperative setting, that means before surgery. It's been shown that proton therapy results in significantly less radiation dose going to the heart, the lungs, and the gastrointestinal tract as compared to what we see with traditional radiation therapy techniques. There's some evidence that this can decrease side effects as well as decreasing complications from surgery. Additionally, proton therapy can be used to provide additional dose to the tumor in situations where surgery is not possible for esophageal cancer. Potentially, this could result in improved outcomes. Finally, proton therapy can be used in the situation where a patient has had prior radiation therapy, and we would use proton therapy to retreat the patient, a scenario which is very complex and is often not amenable to other treatment options. Proton therapy can be a good treatment for primary liver cancer, meaning cancers that start within the liver. However, in certain circumstances, proton therapy can be used for limited metastatic cancer in the liver, which is cancer starting in another organ and spreading to the liver. The liver is very sensitive to the effects of radiation therapy, so it's critical that we spare as much of the liver from the effects of radiation therapy as possible when treating liver tumors. We believe that proton therapy is an ideal option for many liver tumors, because it allows maximal sparing of normal liver and allows us to add additional radiation therapy to the tumor, thus increasing the control rates or improving outcomes with treatment. The most common reason someone is not a candidate for proton therapy is if the cancer is not localized, meaning if the cancer has spread widely throughout the body. Proton therapy, like other forms of radiation therapy, is a local treatment, meaning we treat a specific anatomic region of the body. So if the cancer has spread widely, the benefits of proton therapy, or even any form of radiation therapy, may be less. In certain situations, we would consider radiation therapy even in the setting of metastatic disease, meaning it spread outside of the area it started. Typically, those situations are when the sites of metastasis are limited, so a few in number, or in the case where the sites of metastatic disease are causing a specific symptom or are at risk of causing the patient a problem or symptom. From a patient's perspective, proton therapy is very similar to traditional radiation therapy techniques in that it's a non-invasive treatment. Patients would come in for daily radiation treatments, lie on a table, and the proton therapy machine would move around the patient and deliver the radiation. They don't see or feel anything, and then once the machine is turned off, the radiation leaves their body. The side effects from treatment depend on where we're treating in the body and which organs are exposed to the effects of the radiation treatment. Side effects for treating gastrointestinal cancers typically include side effects such as loss of appetite, nausea, or fatigue. However, again, the side effects are really dependent on the site of the body we're treating. So oftentimes we combine proton therapy with other cancer treatments, including chemotherapy, systemic treatments, or surgery. Proton therapy, just like other forms of radiation therapy, can be combined seamlessly with these other treatments. Even in the setting of prior radiation therapy, proton therapy is an option for retreatment, something we call re-irradiation. The reason we consider proton therapy for retreatment is because it results in less exposure of the normal tissues that have had prior radiation exposure. We often work with other cancer specialists throughout the community. So it's possible to receive your cancer treatment in the community and receive proton therapy at MedStar Georgetown University Hospital. The reason to come to MedStar Georgetown University Hospital is that we offer a wide array of radiation therapy options. We have extensive experience in advanced radiation therapy modalities, including proton therapy, as well as other modalities like CyberKnife. Additionally, we are a comprehensive cancer center, and we offer services with expertise in medical oncology, surgery, and you can have your cancer team under one roof. Our Proton Center is on site within our cancer center, offering easy access to the other services.